Hi guys, welcome back to another part of Android tutorial. Today we are going to learn about another basic view component in Android called the autocomplete text view. An autocomplete text view is a subclass of text view used in Android, and an autocomplete text view will provide some suggestions when the user types some input values in that text box. So today here I am going to demonstrate how we use the autocomplete text view programmatically in an Android project. So here I just create a new project called Basic View. So the first step, I have to place an autocomplete text view on the layout XML file. So open up the layout folder and open up the activity, open up the layout.xml file. So here I just going to place the autocomplete text view. I just provide an ID for the autocomplete text view. I name it as auto names. Now I have to set layout for the autocomplete text view. Android layout. I just set the width as match parent. Now I have to set the height of the autocomplete text view. I make it as wrap content. Okay. The next step is to code the autocomplete text view. So open up the src folder, expand the package and go to the main activity.java file. So first I have to create an array that store the suggestion value. I have to create a string array. In that array I just save some values for getting suggestions. Okay, I just create an array, string array, and I just save some values in that string array for getting the suggestion, automatic suggestion. Okay, now I have to create an object of autocomplete text view. I just create an object of autocomplete text view. I give it as text view. Now I just connect this object to the ID provided on the layout file using the method find view by ID. r.id. It is auto names. So here a casting is needed because it is an object. Okay. So the next step is to create an array adapter, create an object of array adapter class. So I just create an array adapter class here, array adapter. It is of string type. Array adapter, I give it as adapter is equal to new array adapter. It is of string type. First argument is the context. Now I have to provide a style for the autocomplete text view, android.r.layout. Symbol drop down item 1 line. This is the appropriate style for the autocomplete text view. Now I have to connect the array to this array adapter here. Array is the name. Okay, I just create an array adapter class here. Some arrays are present here. Array adapter is equal to new array adapter. New array adapter of type string. Okay, now I have to connect, I have to set threshold for the text view, autocomplete text view. A threshold is the number of characters that are required by for getting the suggestion. So here I have to set the threshold for the autocomplete text view. Set threshold, I give it as 3. This is because whenever the threshold means this is the minimum number of characters needed for getting the autocomplete, getting the automatic suggestions on the autocomplete text view. If I just provide 3, so in this case I have to type at least 3 characters for getting the automatic suggestion on the autocomplete text view. Okay, now I have to connect this array adapter object to the autocomplete text view. So text view dot set adapter, here object is adapter. Okay, now this is the time to run the project. So now I'm going to run the project. Okay, the project is successfully launched on the emulator. So here I just type the you can see that whenever I type 3 characters, the suggestions will automatically appear. That's why I provide set threshold as 3. If you provide threshold as 2, whenever you type 2 characters, the suggestions will appear. Also, you can see that other name is also appear here. This is how we using an autocomplete text view in an Android project. The symbols. Some simple steps here. First step on, you have to create a string for storing the suggestion values. Now here I just create an autocomplete text view object. Second, you have to create an array adapter class here. In this array adapter, I just use the style called the symbol drop down item one line, and here you have to provide the final argument as the name of the array on which the suggestions are stored. So by you have to set the threshold using set threshold method. By using this method, you can set the minimum number of characters needed for the autocomplete text view for showing the automatic suggestion. Finally, you have to use the method called the set adapter for connecting the adapter to the text view, autocomplete text view. Okay guys, this is how we using an autocomplete text view in an Android project. Please subscribe my channel now for getting further video updates. Also, you can get the source code of this topic from my blog. The URL of my blog is given under the description of this video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next part of this tutorial.